really, you know, pain to the heart.
Timmy Austin, thank you very much. Bob and Ferdy, it's all yours.
All right, thank you very much, Wally Matthews. And Tim Austin will get Benjamin Mangwata on Tuesday. Mangwata completes his second come-from-behind win of the games. He won 8-7, Ferdy, as our viewers had a chance to see the right arm being raised.
Which means in the third round, he won 5-2. I'm sorry, I didn't see that as a 5-2 round, but Mangwata has done it twice. I told you he's tough, and he keeps on coming. He won't be discouraged. I thought Freitas won, but I wouldn't argue with this. I would not argue with this.
Well, on Tuesday afternoon, Tim Austin against Benjamin Mangwata. And right now, action in the flyweight category continuing. Raul Gonzalez of Cuba, 25 years of age in round number one. He defeated Olszewski of Poland, 15-7. And there's Moses Malagu of Nigeria, 19 years of age. On Monday, he took care of Buttermer of Ireland by a 12-8 score. And once again, the Nigerian noisemakers are out. Cuba 17-1 in the Olympic Games, 7-0 in the second round.
Again, we say they're a well-schooled team. Again, we say they're professionals. And to add to the problems of the red team, it's looking like the blue corner is always the right button on the computer. Right-handed men have a tendency to be able to handle the right hand more than the left, and therefore there's an advantage. If that's not absurd, I don't know what is. I'm going to quit saying it.
We begin round one, and right now Raul Gonzalez of Cuba fighting out of the red corner, a strong fighter with limited international experience. One of the few right-handed Cuban fighters.
Yep.
And referee Garbo of Denmark asking the fighters to break.
Malagu of Cuba is much taller and certainly faster and sharper. Moses Malagu, I erroneously said a moment ago, was in the red, but he's not. He's in the blue.
And a standing eight count for Malagu after Gonzalez has put the pressure on and come out bombing here in this first round.
Obviously, they are trained to take the first round. They do not fool around.
Well, Gonzalez, Cuban teammates standing and cheering for him. And the Nigerian noisemakers quiet. Good left hand by Gonzalez.
I hate rattlesnakes. Worse than anything in the world. That's what they sound like.
Well, that's the Nigerian noisemakers. Right hand by Gonzalez. Another right by Gonzalez scores. Malagu has been doing some work to the body, but those tough to be picked up by the judges.
Well, you get the idea. These Cuban fighters go for a knockout from the first round. I mean, they just don't want to leave it alone. They're right on top of taking care of this. Well-trained, well-schooled, in
good left
hand condition
by Malagu, but it doesn't affect Gonzalez one bit.
Gonzalez just looks like he's punching the bag. Oh, look at that. Look at those two punches.
And a second standing eight count here in round one to Moses Malagu. One more in the round, and the fight would be stopped. Two more over the next two rounds, and it will be stopped.
Not enough time. Not enough time.
And there's the bell to end round number one. A very, very solid round for Raul Gonzalez of Cuba. 9-2 his lead in 30. I'll tell you, it could have been bigger.
Yeah, 9-2 is kind of nice. Well, it doesn't make it. It was 9-2 is so big, especially when you've had a two standing eight counts, that it's hard to overcome.
And let's take a look at some of the work of Gonzalez. And Gonzalez just very, very impressive. The straight right hand, and he just kept Malagu right in front of him.
And it's not just one right hand, but a waterfall of right hands. It was a sort of poignant moment when our camera picked up Malagu's shrug and shaking his head. Coach is exhorting him. He just shook his head like saying, yeah, but.
You get in there.
But I got this guy in front of me with a red headgear that's killing him.
Well, Malagu comes out and tries to trade with Gonzalez to start round two, and this could be a mistake as well.
Well, I tell you what, when you're down 9-2 and you're facing a superior opposition, it's not a mistake. That is the only thing left to him. He might as well hope that he gets lucky. Maybe he'll land a shot. Maybe it'll be some kind of injury. What?
And they're going to clear some blood away from the face of Malagu. This is referee Peter Gardbo of Denmark. He was temporarily suspended for 2 days because he did not deem a fight should be stopped. And they needed a doctor to basically yell at him and say, stop this fight.
I think there's a cut, and the cut may be bad enough to stop this. Yeah, I think that's what happened. That's it. Cuban gets to save his energy. Raul Gonzalez.
So at 23 seconds of round number two, this contest stopped by the referee because of an injury, a cut to Moses Malagu. And it really wouldn't have mattered because the scoreboard read 12-2 at the time of the stoppage, and we were just 23 seconds in to the second round. So that's the kind of work, and there's the cut on Malagu's eye.
Well, that's really not a nasty cut under the eye. I mean, under the eye doesn't hurt anything. Would have been a lot of blood. He was so far behind, I agree with it.
So Raul Gonzalez of Cuba, another impressive Cuban fighter. They are now 18-1 in the Olympic Games and 8-0 in the second round. And Moses Malagu has nothing to be ashamed of.
No, he was. It's one of those things where he's giving good competition, a good clean fight, but losing way down the road. He wasn't getting his clock clean. He was just losing. The guy's just outspeeding him, but that cut under the eye, you know, in a close fight.